Welcome to Corporal's Corner. Today I'm going to use a grabber all-weather blanket and create a shelter called a freestanding wedge. So stick around, we have a great show for you. This past week, a friend of mine and fellow instructor by the name of Matt Mercer of Black Hat Bushcraft went ahead and put out a video called The Bipod Tarp Shelter. Reality is just a fancy name for a freestanding wedge. But what I liked about the video was that he showed and explained thoroughly the true beauty of that system or that setup. And that is, it gives you the freedom to place your shelter wherever you see fit, versus having the terrain dictate where you place it. Let's say that you're in a large opening and it's getting late and you realize that you got to bed down for the night. Or let's say that you're in a barren wasteland like this. Worst case, that wooded area that you come across, the trees are spread that far apart to where a normal 25 to 50 foot ridgeline won't suffice. Well, that's where your freestanding wedge comes into play. So today what I thought I would do is go ahead and do two things. First off, give Matt Mercer at Black Hat Bushcraft a shout out and let you guys know that if you're looking for another no BS, no fluff channel that's well explained and well shot, head over there, check him out, show him some love and subscribe. But number two, most importantly, is going through my videos, I realized that I haven't demoed this shelter yet. So guess what? Today's the day. Let's go ahead and get started. Go ahead and kick this off with a bipod lash or a shear lash. So all I'm gonna do is begin with a timber hitch. I'm gonna start about 4 to 6 inches down. And I'm gonna take my number 36 bank line. I'm gonna wrap it around. And then twist it underneath itself 3 to 5 times. And then pull it tight. Now I'm going to wrap around 3 times. Now from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap between it. Those are called fraps. So just taking it. I'm going to wrap it around the inside 3 times. And pull it tight. After we pulled our last frap tight, we're going to finish off right here with a clove hitch. So all we're going to do is go around. Cross over itself. It creates an X right there. Now we're going to run our bank line underneath that X. We'll just dress it up. Pull it tight and then finish off with an overhand knot or a pretzel knot. Went ahead and laid my tarp out, stake down my back corner. My front corner, I take my bowline to tie your bowline. Go ahead and take one end. All you're gonna do is rotate it so it's on top. Take your end, come out of the hole, go around that tree, and back inside that hole. Pull it tight. Pass it through that grommet. Grab a toggle. Place it through there. And it will lock it in place. Now I can feed this over top of my bipod and tie it off to my stake using a trucker's hitch or tautline hitch. So take our line, go around our stake. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and twist my line towards my stake, form a loop, lay that loop down, reach inside, pull it through. Now taking my other end, I'm gonna go ahead and pass it through my loop. I'm gonna pull it towards my stake. The more I pull it, the tighter it's gonna be. I'm gonna pinch my loop and my line together. Go ahead and drape this over. Reach inside, pull it through. Now for our tautline hitch, go around our stake. I'm gonna drape it back over. We're on top. I'm gonna go around once. Go around twice. We're gonna go back around the outside. And pull the excess through. Then we'll cinch it down. And pull it tight. Thank you. Welcome back. In my opinion, the freestanding wedge is outstanding, strictly for the reason that I mentioned before, and that is, it allows you the freedom to place that shelter wherever you see fit. Now do me a favor, head over to Black Hat Bushcraft, hit the subscribe button and notification bell on both of our channels, and as always, thank you for your comments, views, support, thanks for watching. Be out in the field, have some fun, I'm gonna catch you next time.